Hey guys, so this is going to be a kind of discussion video, something I wanted to talk about in regards to my own self and how I do things, and about the title. I'm not really saying how do you trust new authors, like authors that have been just published their first book or whatever, though I guess they're kind of included too, sort of. What I mean is like trusting authors that are new to you, because I'm very skeptical personally of picking up books by authors I've never read before, which is a problem, or it has been a problem in the past, sort of. Basically, it's difficult for me to feel like I can pick up a book by an author I've never heard of before, or a book I've never heard of, which kind of translates into why I pick up books, and how I pick up books, and when, and all that. And there was a point, mostly throughout college, when I was always too busy to seek out new authors, so I just kind of reread the same stuff a whole bunch. Stuff I already knew I loved, because I just didn't want to pick up a book I didn't know, or an author I didn't know, and not like it. So I read a ton of Stephen King, I read the Harry Potter series and the Pendragon series over and over again, and it was kind of bad and kind of hindered my reading progression, I guess. And ever since I found Booktube, though, it's gotten like way better the way I choose books to read, and that's really the point of this video, is like a perfect combination of who the author is, what the cover looks like, what the title is, what the blurb says about the book, what the first sentence is, and what people whose opinions I trust have said about it. And it's not like it's just one person either. I need like multiple people that like the same books I do to shove a book in my face before I give it a shot, usually. Or if that hasn't happened, the book has to specifically look really interesting to me for whatever reason, or I have to be really interested in reading it. Whatever is the strongest emotion towards a book that I haven't read yet at that point, and depending on each book individually. So the reason I wanted to make this little video is because it feels like I'm one of the only people that has this problem. I mean, yes, other people are like shallow as I am about book covers, and of course people generally pick up books they think will be interesting, but it seems a lot of booktubers can just randomly pick up books and somehow end up giving them a bunch of books, low ratings, because they weren't really what that booktuber was into, and it's just weird to me, that's all. And with all of this talk going around Booktube recently about reading critically and about ratings, I just wanted to clear something up about myself personally. I give a lot of 4 and 5 stars, because I almost never, I mean, sometimes things slip through and I thought I'd like something and ended up disappointing me or whatever, but I almost never pick up a book unless I'm pretty damn sure I'm really going to like it first. And it can't just sound okay to me, like I have to be really, really interested in it. So I give good ratings because I know my taste and I know what I like. And anyway, how I rate books is actually the topic of another video, what I'm going to make like right after this one, and I'll post sometime later this week or something. But what I wanted to ask, I guess, is if anyone is as picky as I am when they pick up a book. Like, there are plenty of books that people on here are reading that look mildly interesting, that some people like well enough, and there might be, like, a lot of people picking those books up, but a lot of them just don't appeal to me in a sort of perfect way. Like, the combination of things I just listed just doesn't add up to me being really interested in it, which I need to be to pick something up. And anyway, I just wanted to ask opinions on this. Like, do you have that same problem as I do? Because it literally, it keeps me from picking up a lot of books, and in a lot of ways, that's a really good thing, because it keeps me from reading books that are just a waste of time. Like, I feel like a lot of people really waste their time on books that just aren't for them, and I don't really understand how you can pick up a book and not realize before you even pick it up that it's not for you, because it hardly ever happens to me. Like, it hardly ever happens to where I pick up a book, I think I'm really gonna like it, and that's because I pick up books because I only think I'm gonna like them, and I pick it up and it disappoints me. That hardly ever happens. I mean, I might give like a book 3.5 stars or 3 stars or whatever, and like it might just be like kind of meh or whatever, but it hardly ever I pick up a book that grants, like it warrants a 2 stars even. Like, that's hardly ever happens for me, and I just think it's weird, and I don't know if anybody else has that going on. And I'm not like complaining, I'm really happy about it actually. Like, I'm pretty sure that I review and read fairly critically in my reading and in my reviews. I usually am pretty critical of things and I try to give an actual opinion, but usually that opinion is favorable because I generally only pick up books I like. And really there have only been a few books this year that I've sat down and reviewed that I didn't like, and those were just ones that were just disappointing. But yeah, like I said, hardly ever happens. I might be really weird, I don't know. It just seems that way based on other BookTubers' experiences and my experience watching other BookTubers. So that's everything I wanted to say. Be on the lookout for a video on how I give ratings, because I think that's kind of important to your understanding of my reviews and my ratings. And I hope that video will help you understand, like, translate your rating system to my rating system. Like, and I think it's really important. And I'm kind of glad that this conversation has been brought up on BookTube, although I'm kind of late to the party of it, but whatever. Anyway, that's all I wanted to say. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you again with more later.